The next presenter is Antoine Bruyère. He's going to talk about a simplified approach for frequency dynamics assessment of 100% power electronic based systems. Antoine passed his PhD in electrical engineering in 2009. He spent 10 years in automotive industry at Valeo Powertrain Electronics Product Group, working as an expert in automotive electrification. In 2016, he became assistant professor at Central Lille Institute in the Laboratory of Electrical Engineering of Lille. He transferred his expertise in the field of renewable energy integration on power grid using power electronics converter. Antoine, you are here, but if I understand correctly, I will play the presentation.
Yes, if you want to launch the video, that's perfect.
I'll gladly.
Good morning, and thank you to be present for this presentation about a simplified approach for frequency dynamics assessment of a power electronics-based system. This work was prepared in the context of a collaboration between EDF, Électricité de France, and the L2EP, the Laboratory of Electrical Engineering of Lille. I am Antoine Bruyère, and I will present this paper following this agenda. After a general introduction, I will present the methodology used to perform a frequency analysis on a multi-area power grid. Then, I will present the results observed on a two-area power grid. And at last, I will conclude and give some perspectives. So let's start with the general introduction. The context is the one of massive integration of renewable energy on power grid using power electronics converters. These converters are controlled in grid-forming control mode, so they give assistance on frequency stability. The objective is about the methodology to perform a frequency stability analysis on a large power grid with several frequency areas. And we want to verify the impact of replacing turbo generators by power electronics on the quality of frequency analysis results. The studied system is the well-known standard four generators two-area system, for which each generator will be either a turbo generator system using synchronous machine and turbines, or a power electronics converter operating in voltage-controlled inverter mode, that is also called grid-forming control mode. Let's now detail the methodology to perform a frequency analysis on a multi-area power grid. The proposed method is not new. It is precisely the objective to verify if usual standard methods are still valuable in case of introduction of power electronics on the power system. Here, we will divide the method into three steps. The first one won't be developed. It consists in the division of the power grid into several macro frequency areas. In the second step, we will build simplified models of each area, first by the modeling of generators, then by the aggregation of generators in the same area. In the third step, we'll complete the model by a simplified model of grid lines to get the interactions between active power transfer between areas and areas frequency. Here, we also insist on the notion of simplified model with a reduced set of parameters, because the method must be compatible with global analysis on large power systems. Before dealing with simplified model, we define first the notion of detailed reference model. Indeed, for both turbo generator and power electronics converter, we will first develop a detailed reference model used as a reference to be able to evaluate the quality of the simplified model. Here, the model of turbo generator is a standard one extracted from the literature with the model of a governor and turbines, a DC excitation system, a mechanical swing equation model, and the model of the stator electrical part.
The simplified model of the turbo generator is obtained by keeping only the dominant poles, focusing on the active power path. From left to right, we have the frequency drop with Kp, the drop gain, then the turbines, high pressure and low pressure, with Tau5, the low pressure time constant, and F, the ratio between high pressure and low pressure. On the right side, we have the swing equation with H, the inertia constant, and Kd, the damping factor.
The detailed reference model of the power electronics converter is the following. It's an average model, without switching effect, of a two-level voltage source converter with a perfect DC bus. A LC filter and a transformer are required to connect the converter to the AC grid. As far as control is concerned, there are three main blocks, the IS current loop, the VS voltage loop, and the VCI control block to operate the grid-forming control strategy. The voltage loop is a typical voltage loop achieved in a DQ Park reference frame using PI controllers. The current loop is also a typical current loop achieved in a DQ Park reference frame with PI controllers. The grid-forming control strategy is performed by this VCI control block. It performs an active power control by producing the angle delta. Delta is also the angle to define the DQ Park reference frame in which are achieved the voltage and the current loops. By comparison with the simplified model of turbo generator, this control architecture is very similar, with the same swing equation model, with the same inertial effect, with H, with the same frequency droop. The only differences are the lack of low-pressure turbine effect and the lack of damping through the damping factor Kd. However, to mimic the effect of Kd, we add this lead lag compensator for a damping purpose. Now, to build the simplified model of power electronics converters, we keep only the VCI control block, assuming that all other parts of the detailed model are not required to perform the frequency analysis on the multi-area power system. And this is the assumption we want to verify during the next part of this presentation. Previously, we built the model of the generators, either turbo generator or power electronics converter. Here, we want to build the simplified model of a full area, including several generators. To perform this aggregation, we choose the following assumptions. First, we consider the same nature of generators in a given area. Then, we consider that the frequency is everywhere the same in the area. And at last, since we saw that the models were very similar between turbo generator and power electronics converter, we can use the same aggregation formula as far as H, the inertia, is concerned, and Kp, the drop gain, is concerned. To interconnect the areas to each other, we use the standard model of the matrix of synchronizing torque coefficient Ks. This matrix is a simplified model of the power grid lines focused on the power exchange as a reaction to the electrical positions of the areas. We will now perform a short frequency analysis on the example of the two areas power grid, and we'll compare the two models, the detailed reference one and the simplified one. To perform the frequency analysis, we will play three scenarios. In this first one, we focus on the time domain frequency behavior in case of a load step at bus 7 in area 1. In this slide, we consider four same generators, which are turbo generators. They are sized at 900 MVA and 6.5 seconds for the inertia. The result is the typical and well-known frequency deviation in case of such load step. We observe the droop effect. We observe oscillations around the dominant mode in each area. We observe a higher rockoff in area 1 because the event occurs at bus 7 in area 1, and we observe higher oscillations in area 2. At last, what we observe also is that the simplified model gives a result very close to the detailed reference model, and this justifies the use of the simplified model to perform this kind of frequency analysis. In this second slide, by comparison with the previous one, all the conditions are the same, except we replace the turbo generators by power electronics converters. The observations on the frequency deviation are nearly the same, except we observe here a much better damping of the frequency oscillations. This is justified by the origin of damping. In turbo generators, the damping effect is modeled through the damping factor Kd. But we cannot choose any value for Kd, since Kd is the combination of several phenomena linked with hardware design choice and control design choice. Here, damping effect is linked with the lead lag compensator inside VCI control block. It is exclusively linked with control design, and so we can play on control design tuning to improve damping effect. The last observation on this slide is about the use of the simplified model, which gives results very close to the detailed reference model, and that goes in the direction of the justification of using the simplified model to perform this kind of frequency analysis. To conclude on this scenario, we introduce model error indicators. The mean average error uses the absolute distance between the reference model and the simplified model. The root mean squared error uses the quadratic distance. In the both cases of a full turbo generator grid and of a full power electronics grid, we give both error indicators in both areas 1 and 2. To say if an error is low or high, we define as a reference of acceptable error the case of the full turbo generator grid. And we see that the case of the full power electronics grid gives errors which are always lower. In this second scenario, we consider the case of a full power electronics grid with the same load step at bus 7. The objective is to test the simplified model against the detailed reference model for different configurations in the distribution of inertia between generators. Indeed, for VCI power electronics generator, inertia is a parameter of control that can be chosen at any value, which is not the case with turbo generators. Here, 5 configurations are tested, and for all of these configurations, the model error indicators are at acceptable values. A particular attention is paid on configurations 3 and 4 because they depict quite unusual situation with a disparate distribution of inertia between generators. Here also, the model error indicators are at acceptable value. At last, we make also the observation that the weaker is inertia, the higher is the model error. But for the tested configurations, the model error indicators remain at acceptable values. In the last scenario, we consider a mixed configuration with turbo generators in the first area and power electronics converters in the second one. It is 6.5 seconds for both generators. In the second area, we consider 2 configurations with an aggregated inertia of 6.5 seconds for the configuration 1 and 2.5 seconds for the second configuration. In both cases, the model error indicators are at acceptable levels. Let's now detail the conclusions of the paper and give some perspectives about the actual and future work. One first slide about the conclusion and the perspectives. First, about the targeted objective. We showed we were able to perform a frequency analysis of a multi-area power system with power electronics generators. About the methodology, we remind our wish to keep it standard by aggregation of simplified models of generators. About the quality of the simplified models, we showed that the proposed model of power electronics VCI was as good as the turbo generator reference one, or even better. These conclusions must be moderated by the tested case, reduced to a small 2 areas 4 generator system. So, as perspectives, we now have to consolidate all of these observations by a deeper analysis and extra test cases on larger grid. It's ongoing. We also have to work on the aggregation in the same area of different types of generators, power electronics and turbo generators. One last conclusion, certainly the most important one, about the importance of a control architecture that can be aggregated. Here, we remind the scheme of the turbo generator, the simplified scheme, reduced to the droop function, the model of the turbine, the inertia, and the damping effect. If we compare it with the proposed simplified model of power electronics VCI, we see that we have the same droop function, the same inertia modeling, and an equivalence of damping effect. This was possible because we built the initial architecture of control for the VCI by the inversion of the physical model of the system. This led naturally to the simplified model that gave very encouraging results. If now we want to aggregate it to the model of a turbo generator in the same area, we see that it will be self-evident. Thank you for your attention. We are now available to answer to your questions.
Thanks a lot for Antoine for preparing this presentation for us. There are already two questions in the question and answer panel. Would you mind reading them and addressing them?
Yes. About the first question, I saw it was asked at the first part of the presentation. I suppose that I answered to the question during the presentation. The objective of the methodology was to propose a simplified model of the converter in which we have the same parameters as the typical simplified model of turbo generator with the inertia, and we can play on the value of inertia. About the second question, please let me read. We typically assess frequency containment. Could be a short circuit fault leading to a loss of generation. Such an event affects electrical. It also seems that it is hard to be confident about the behavior of converter. Yes. Yes, we can consider other disturbance on the power grid, and it is also part of my perspective to test more test cases on larger systems, but there's no. It can be tested and it should work.
I see that Arun Kannan, the previous speaker, also would like to chip in here. Let's see.
Yes, thank you. I just wanted to ask, since he has considered a simplified model, can this model also works if I do a disturbance, which is say that the disturbance with respect to the load, if it is larger, or whether I can, or in terms of large disturbance, can it handle? Thank you.
We didn't test yet the limits of the disturbance. Sure, there's a limit with this kind of linear model, linearized model, yes. It must be tested to check the limit.
Okay, we have another minute if anyone wants to ask a question, but it's otherwise, thank you.